let's go ahead and add our serializer to our API view. So we've defined our serializer here in the serializers.py file. Now it's time to add it to the views.py file in our API view or our hello API view. We're going to start by adding a couple of imports here at the top. The first one we're going to import is the serializers file, which we created in the previous lesson. So we're going to type from.import serializers. So as I mentioned previously, the dot imports from the root directory. So we're importing our serializers.py module here. The next import is the status. The status is a list of, or contains a list of different HTTP response status codes. So you may have heard of HTTP 404 or HTTP 505. Now these status codes are all described in the status object of the REST framework. So let's type from REST framework import status. Okay, I'm going to save the file there. And now I'm going to come down to the Hello API view class. Let's tell Django REST framework what serializer we want to use to describe the data that we handle with this API view. So right below the doc string, above the get function, let's add a serializer variable and let's reference our serializer that we created in the previous lesson. So type serializer underscore class equals serializers dot hello serializer. So this tells Django, or it tells the Django REST framework, that the serializer class for this API view is going to be the serializers, which is here, hello serializer object, or class, I should say. Okay, so once we describe the class, let's create a post function. This is going to be the logic that gets called when you make a HTTP post request to our API view. So type def to define the function, post, and we're going to use the parameters self and request. All right, and let's give the doc string create a hello message with our name. So when you make a post to our API view, we're going to return a message that includes the name that was posted to the API. Okay, so first we're gonna set our serializer. So we're gonna create a variable that is our serializer object. So type serializer equals serializers.hello serializer. And we're gonna pass in the data that is handed to this post request. So whenever one of these HTTP method functions is called, there's a request object here. The request object contains details of the request that was made to the API call. That includes the data that you posted. So when you do a HTTP post, you always have a payload of data. That is included in the request object, and we're going to pass it through to our serializer, so it knows which data to base the serializer object on. So after the hello serializer in the brackets, let's type data equals request.data. Okay, so this creates a serializer object with our hello serializer, and it passes in the request data to the data attribute. The next thing to do is validate that the data that's passed in is valid. So we're gonna do an if statement here that checks that the serializer has valid data passed into it. So type if serializer.isValid. So if it's valid, we wanna return a response. So first we're gonna set the name, a variable called name equals serializer.get dot data, or sorry, serializer dot data dot get name. So once we call isValid, all of the data that's passed into the serializer is available in this data dictionary. We can retrieve specific fields by typing the serializer dot data and using the dot get function, and then the name of the field we want to get the data from. So in this case, we want to get the name that the user entered and assign it to a variable called name. Once we've done that, we can create a message based on that name. So we're just going to create a simple string, and we're going to write message equals and create a string hello, and we're going to use the proper Python string notation here. This curly brackets 0.format and then the name. So what this does is it creates a string, and then in the string we're passing in the name using the format function of the string. This is a function in Python. This is how you should create strings properly. So if you wanted to create multiple different or insert multiple different items in the string, you would use these curly brackets and use the order that you want them to go in. So 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. And you would add them to this format. We only want to insert one item to the string. So we're just going to type 0, and we're just going to pass the name in as the format. Okay, so now that we've assigned a name and a message, let's return it as an object, as a response object. So type return response, and then we're going to pass a dictionary that has a key message, and we're going to pass in the message object to that message key. Okay, so that's all good if the data is valid, but if the user entered invalid data when it was passed to the serializer and the validation failed, we want to return the error message to the user so they know what they did wrong. So we're going to put an else statement here, and we're going to type return, and we're going to return a response object, but this time we're going to put the data as the serializers or the serializer.errors. So if you call isValid and it returns false, then there'll be an errors dictionary assigned to the serializer. This will contain a list of all the errors that occurred when we were validating the data. The second thing we're going to specify in the request is the status code. So we want to give an accurate status code so that the app or whatever is consuming our API knows what went wrong. So we're going to type status equals status.http_400_bad_request. So the HTTP 400 bad request is the standard status code to be used when you do a bad request to an API. So a bad request is either you called something that you weren't supposed to call, or you put data in there that you weren't supposed to put. So there was an invalid data. So it was a bad request to the API. I'm gonna bring this down to the line below so that we keep it within this maximum line limit here. And that's all we need to do to configure our serializer in our API view. So you can save the file. That's how you create a post request or a post function and add a serializer class to an API view. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.